Adam, it's amazing to have you here with us at Showmasters. Can you talk about why this film is so iconic and still so very much beloved?
It's hard to say. I think a lot of it would have to do with the way that the characters are developed in it, perhaps. Like, you really get to watch the children bond in this version, and that really speaks to what the movie is about. It's about kids bonding to conquer something that is larger than them, and it has a really good message to it in that way. I mean, it's also got some murder and clowns killing everyone, but it's a really good show to see that children can bond in that way and overcome something.
Can you talk about your character and what it was you identified with when you saw the script, when you saw the character at first?
I think being the youngest of the group helped with that, and like my mother was actually very supportive of everything, and not at all like my mom and it, fortunately. But it was that sort of being that age and not really understanding the world quite as well, and then that's kind of what I see Eddie's character doing. Is he's young, he's sort of repressed by his mother, not really allowed to do something, so you get to see this child kind of open up and find friends and become part of something larger, and so that was kind of what I identified with that.
Can you talk a little bit about what your experience was like working with the amazing Tim Curry, and why you think the character remains such an icon?
It was fantastic working with him. I mean, a consummate professional, his work speaks for itself. I would say that one of the things that I learned from him was, as a young actor at that age, like I still hadn't really developed a style or whatever. And so it was watching someone with that body of work and that level of experience, and the way that he would be dressed in full makeup, full costume and everything, and still be very relaxed off camera. He would occasionally play jokes on everyone and, you know, still kind of creep out some of the kids, but my experiences with him was watching him be able to just sort of be himself, studying his lines and having a smoke or having some coffee, and then as soon as the camera was on, immediately snapping into one of the most iconic performances of all time. And so that was a great learning experience for me, being able to see someone who could turn the acting on and off like that, and it sort of became a model of something I tried to do for the last few years of my career when I was doing that. It's harder for me to define, but I guess one of the easiest ways to define it is, if you don't mind, in relation to the modern Pennywise in the more recent movie, where I find that Tim's performance is, I wouldn't say more nuanced, but you get a chance to see the clown as the clown. Like, there are parts of the movie where he's hilarious and being goofy and being like an actual clown would be, and just kind of being this random, goofy, weird person, and then watching that very non-threatening clown that's just kind of weird slowly, or sometimes even quickly, change into the demonic character that he is and the thing that really scares you and is going to kill you. And I think that's, at least for me, what defines that role as something that's so iconic, because you don't always see that horror coming and then it snaps up out of nowhere. My experience with him was seeing him more behind the scenes. My mother took a lot of pictures of random things happening on set while we were doing that, and one of my favorite ones that I've been always sticks in my mind is of him, obviously getting the makeup on was a huge ordeal, so it was like a two-hour process. My mom happened to have a candid shot of him coming out of the makeup trailer when all he has on is just the head makeup and no costume, anything else, so he's just in like a white t-shirt and like jeans or pajama pants. So I got more of my experience was watching Tim as the clown still being just a normal person, and I really enjoyed that aspect of it.
You mentioned there, obviously, the recent remake. I'm curious if you watched that and how you felt about how the two versions compared in terms of what they gave audiences.
Two completely different things. I have seen it, obviously. I would be weird if I hadn't. But it's a very different interpretation of the story, and I really enjoy it for what it does. I like the way that it's been modernized, and I love some of the aspects of it where so finely nuanced. Like, one of my favorite things about it is when they are fighting the clown, fighting Pennywise in the first one, for the first time in the Centrum or whatever they call it, and they hit him in the face and blood comes out and the blood floats upwards. That, I thought that was an amazing touch to it. But they are two different, two completely different reimaginings of that tale. Like, the first one is a little bit more story-driven and character-driven, whereas the second one is more about, in my mind anyway, how evil the clown is, and like the, it's a little bit more scary, I guess you'd say.
Of all the genres of cinema, the horror genre seems to have the most loyal and devoted fans. What is it about horror that inspires that passion?
I mean, if I had to say psychologically, I think because of the terror that it invokes, you get that sort of trauma bonding. Like, you feel that experience with the characters, and like, especially since we're like the heroes of it, you get that sort of aspect where it's like, well, that would have been a terrible movie, but you did watch the children triumph. So it has this whole interactive experience where you are traumatized and then it's over. And so you really have that experience of bonding with that movie. It's really pretty cool. Thanks for continuing to be fans of this for something that, as being a 12-year-old, I had no idea it would take on this sort of life that it has. And it's fantastic that everyone is still so into it. So thank you for watching and still being fans.